adult things, things that I've seen other adults do in movies, things that adults only do in private, things that I am positive my parents don't do anymore. Yeah, I'm gonna vote. States that an enlightened citizenry is indispensable for the proper functioning of a republic. But most young people don't know John Kerry from John Kennedy, and I'd hate to see them pronounce John Boehner. So that's why I've come down here to Oaklawn's Board of Trustees meeting this month and have demanded to speak to you. And by demanded, I mean I got here early and I signed up. So you don't have this voting thing, you can just wait your turn. This board plays a crucial role in solving this problem. Today's youth are not getting actively involved in politics, and if we don't exercise our political rights, we will undermine our role in this democracy. So first, we'll see why the youth don't care about the red or blue, examine the consequences of our politically silent youth, before finally, democratically voting on some solutions. Young people today don't know about politics for two reasons, because they are ignorant to the process, and the process is ignorant to them. So we're all just stupid, right? Don't you nod your head, Mrs. Wilkinson. Teens are ignorant about politics because their parents want them to be. It sounds crazy, but the University of Massachusetts did a study on this in 2013, and they found that 64% of parents did not want their child to receive an education on current political events. The fear was that one day, they'd all grow up to become politicians, which I admit is scary. Therefore, with no other choice, teachers are forced to focus on past events instead of current ones. For example, John Adams, born October 30, 1735. Presidential term, March 4, 1797 to March 4, 1801. He had three brothers and went to Harvard when he was 16. John McCain, he's American. So basically, for fear that their children will become politicians, parents are keeping their kids ignorant about politics. Parents, simple solution, don't name your kids John. But aside from that, do you feel sure that their political ideals are represented in any particular party? According to a December 2014 article from The Guardian, teenagers would much rather focus on individual issues rather than the Democratic or Republican agenda. The article goes on to say that you feel that the two major parties don't accurately reflect their values, and there are no viable third-party options to choose from. It's like, no one wants to go to a zoo with only elephants and donkeys. What about the penguins? Or the zebras? Or, oh my god, those cute monkeys with their butts showing! That's what I want! John Butt Monkey, 2016! The political version of that. So, what happens when youth don't know how to contribute to our democracy? Well, one, they don't take an active role in it, and two, they have no effect on it. First, youth are not taking active roles in politics. As a result of a lack of education on how our government currently works, youth are turning to alternative sources to learn and share their political ideals. In 2014, the School of Politics and